Hi there. I'd like to talk to you for a few minutes as ministry leaders about giving, and I'm not going to keep you very long. First, let me say how difficult and awkward it can be, and I know that it can be like that, to talk about money in the context of the church. Sometimes it feels like we're trying to fundraise just for our own salaries, just to pay our own bills, and there's nothing fun about that. What I'd like to suggest today is that we think about giving as a spiritual practice and that we talk about it all year round. Talking about giving all year round is more effective, I think, and more important than saving it all up for one big clumsy stewardship season in the fall. And I've preached my share of those clumsy stewardship sermons myself. Talking about giving throughout the year also frees us from linking the spiritual practice of giving to the tyranny of budgets. As spiritual leaders, our task is not to massage budgets, but to offer ministry, service, and care, and education, and so on. And deep within the heart of ministry, and this is really at the heart of what I want to say to you today, deep within the heart of ministry is that opportunity we have to encourage folks in their spiritual lives. Just as we have a ministry of encouraging spiritual practices like Bible reading and prayer and gathering together in worship and serving others, giving is also a spiritual practice that we have the opportunity to encourage in folks. Giving alongside other spiritual practices helps us to become the people that God would have us be. In this world of individualism and consumerism, the spiritual practice of giving radically connects us to the people around us. It's a way of expressing love. It's a way of forming new relationships. It's a way of being radically freed from being captive to consumerism and consumption. So I'm going to go out on a bit of a limb here and suggest that the spiritual practice of giving actually helps to transform us into being more Christ-like, more Spirit-led persons, and it helps to reshape our communities in a more Godward direction. The letter to the Galatians says that the fruit of the Spirit are love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, gentleness, generosity, faithfulness, self-control. Did you hear that word, generosity? It's not a strange or unwelcome thought that Christians are generous people. We just need a little help sometimes, a little bit of coaching to keep discovering that deep truth. Christians are meant to be generous people. It's part of the DNA of this whole Jesus movement. It's close to the heart of what it means to be people of the Spirit. Thanks for spending a few minutes with me. My prayer for you is that you will have a spirit of courage and joy as you share the good news about the spiritual practice of giving. Be bold, be loving, be hopeful. God be with you.